Yeshiva World.
That's what it means to be a leader. I am thankful to HaKadosh Baruch Hu that I have had over 40 years of my life. Somebody may be wondering, he's only been in office 35. But all my life, I'm very proud of this. I have been involved in fighting for the Jewish community. I have been involved in trying to make a difference, going back to the Soviet Jewry movement, Syrian Jewry, anti-Semitism, Jewish poor. You know, a long time ago, they discovered, back in the 70s, they thought all Jews were rich. So whatever programs existed, the Jewish community did not benefit. And I was out there fighting way before I ever dreamed or thought of being an elected official. Let me tell you something, and you know this, experience. When I was elected 35 years ago, I had no experience, ladies and gentlemen. That's what my opponent said, who was in office. I had no experience. By the way, I have a BA in political science. I have an MA in political science. I work towards my PhD in political science. But all of that political science added up to zero in terms of understanding how to deal in a community, how to deal with sanitation, with police, with other elected officials. Let me tell you what you have to have. You have to have a heart, and a real heart. We're living in difficult times. You know, over here today, you know, it sounds like everything is wonderful. Things are difficult, things are tough. We're living in difficult times, and we don't quite know where we're going, whether it's the anti-Semitism, you know, all the swastikas, what is that all about? What's going on? Who's behind this? Does it mean anything? Or should we just shove it under the rug? Ladies and gentlemen, you have to have a heart. If you come in with a heart, someone that cares. By the way, Yoni Hikind spent 10, 12 years. Let me tell you what he did, 10, 12 years. He saved lives. I have met strangers in the street, I don't even know their names, who came over to me and said, your son saved my son's life. Oh, that's not a big deal, I imagine. He doesn't know that many elected officials. You know, he grew up in our home. Senators, governors, mayors sat at our table for meals on Shabbos. He doesn't know elected officials. You think it's that complicated to get to know elected officials? You're going to be nice to Yoni when he gets elected.
Yes?
You're going to be, of course she'll be nice. Once he's elected, she'll be very nice to him, and so will every other elected official. I never knew that one of the qualifications is knowing a lot of elected officials. You think it's so complicated to figure this out? Yeah, you need to really care deeply. And to those who listened to Yoni this morning, how real, how emesic, how straight he is. If it didn't touch your heart, then I don't understand. This is a great opportunity for the community. And by the way, it will be an earthquake. What happens a week from Tuesday is going to be unbelievable in our community. And it's all about caring for everybody. That's all it is. It's not complicated. It's not about good guys and bad guys, and it's not about intimidating people, threatening people. None of that goes on, of course, in our community. You think anybody's being intimidated? You want to listen to videos? You want to listen to voice recordings of people getting phone calls, being threatened? Would you like to? So the point is, this organization, you were there for me. You are the leaders. You understand. You get it. And we have an opportunity to elect someone. And I wasn't going to get into all the politics, but David sort of, you know, did that, which is fine. He could be committed. That's wonderful. But let me tell you, each and every one of you, I'm looking at you. You have an extraordinary individual in Yoni. I'm going to tell you something, maybe I shouldn't say it, but some of you will understand it's right after Yom Kippur. Maybe some, you know, I just thought about this about a week ago. Never said it before a week ago. I have never seen my children, any of them, indulge in Lashon Hara. Ever. You hear what I'm telling you? Do you believe me? I was thinking about my wife. I have. I try to stay away from it. I know it's a very serious thing in Judaism to speak evil, to be mean-spirited, to undermine, to attack someone because they're not married, because they don't have a Yiddish upon them. That was an ad in the newspaper, in the Yiddish papers. The headline was that one particular candidate sitting here has a Heimish upon him. Someone said to me, that's anti-Semitic. To do something like that is a horrible thing. But that was the ad in the Yiddish papers. By the way, not in Hamadia. We're voting for someone because they have a Heimish upon him. By the way, am I Heimish enough for you guys after 35 years? Am I losing the next election? By the way, are any of these candidates Heimish? You know what Heimish means? You gotta have a certain look. Do I have the look? Kalman has the look. Sometimes. Sometimes not. But ladies and gentlemen, let it be about the issues. Let it be about the things that matter. Not about how much experience does someone have in politics. By the way, if I was voting on that basis, I would vote for Kalman. He has more experience in politics. But it's not about that. We need people who are real and strong. We need people. I have spent 35 years, and you know it. Everybody in the street knows it. Caring about every single individual. Traveling around the world to be there for a fellow Jew. Going to Vermont with a family, Hasidic family, so they wouldn't be in court by themselves. You know the story about Vermont. That's what it's all about. It's about the extra mile. It's about if we're in trouble, who is going to be there? Yoni has had the kind of training that is unheard of in a home that is purely chesed. And as I finish, I want to share this great Dvar Torah with you. Words of Torah. Beautiful. Just heard it, been repeating it nonstop. I saw this message about that God created the world, but he didn't complete it. He left something open. We become partners with God in completing the world. What a beautiful thought. I am a partner with God. I gotta do better. I gotta do more. Okay, fine. We do a lot, but I gotta do more. Gotta be even better. But we become partners with God when we do good. So, Yoni Hikind, I can say, if you think I'm good, I actually feel that Yoni Hikind is a little better because I have never heard him speak Lashon Hara my entire life. That's quite amazing because some people indulge in it nonstop. God bless each and every one of you. And Hashem has already determined what's going to happen on November 7th. We're just doing our Shabbos. But go to the debate tonight, the Hamadiyah debate. Go to it. You saw the New York One interview between the candidate with all the experience and Yoni Hikind. Go to the debate tonight and listen carefully about the issues, and it becomes very clear. Anyway, God bless each and every one of you, and thank you very much for having the patience and listening. And let me just say hello to the greatest chief. Chief, this man over here you're looking at is the very, very best of the New York City Police Department. Fabulous. And by the way, the guy next to him is a superstar, Yitzi Javlin, whose father was my chief of staff 35 years ago. God bless all of you. Thank you for the patience.